I want to introduce to you Ora Watson and Mary Greene and Cecil Gurganus from over near Boone in North Carolina. Ora Watson has been playing the fiddle since she was 11 years old. Now she's 90, and I believe, well, I don't know, I didn't do very well in math. I'll leave that to you to figure out, but that sounds like about 79 years of playing the fiddle. And she plays it wonderfully, with so much spirit and so much verve, and with white cowboy boots, and I just don't know how you can beat that. Mary Greene teaches Appalachian music at Appalachian State University over in Boone, North Carolina. Cecil Gurganus has been very, very active as a musician. Please, with your hands, welcome Ora Watson, Mary Greene, and Cecil Gurganus.
Start off with a tune that Ora learned when she's fairly young from her cousin Charlie Isaacs, who was a champion fiddler down there at that time in North Carolina. And it's an unusual tune. We haven't heard many people play it besides her. It's called Whistle Britches. Hearing her play. It's called Lonesome Road Blues, and it's got some nice little licks on the fiddle. And I'm gonna get her to grin at me real good, yeah? Thank you.
Thank you so much. We have a good time playing with Ora. She's really taught us a lot of tunes through the years, and just her energy for all types of music. She sings and plays guitar, she plays the banjo, and she dances real well. This next tune that we're going to play is a tune that she really doesn't like. But she's playing this. I don't know why she's playing this for me, maybe.
Because we like it. She's humoring us.
But she did say that this is a great tune to play for a fiddle contest. So this is a tune called Lost John.
Changed for what they were listed. So she's played a lot of country music over the years. She's played a lot of bluegrass. This is an old, really rock and roll tune, okay? And then she plays old time too. So her music really reflects these changes that, I mean, the thing I love about her is her ear is still quick. She wants to learn, and there's incredible things stored in that mind. A lot of music there. Let's do Mockingbird Hill.
Thank you.
Ora, we're going to do Down Yonder next. Is there anything you want to say about Down Yonder?
I don't think so.
That's what you got.
It's a good dance tune.
All right, it's a good dancing tune. It is one of her favorites. The gals that played early this morning, I got to see them. They were wonderful. The Dowden sisters. I was about to say it and afraid I would do it wrong, so thanks. And we had a wonderful band called the Kathleen Hens, and we played some fiddlers' conventions and surprised them because we all danced and played simultaneously. And it was no low energy event. That was when she was in her upper 60s and I was in my lower 20s. And now I'm in my mid 40s and she's definitely gone over the 9-0 mark. And I'm so grateful that we're able to play and be together because it's just a joy. And my mother was her classmate in school. Mama was born in 1912 and my dad was born in 1897. And so as we come along, we're going to do a few songs that I learned from him because he was of her generation or even older. Let's do East Virginia Blues.
Yeah.
they're appreciating your singing. Okay? Yes, I want to see that. See that? All right. She was collected from in the 1960s by Thomas Burton down at ETSU and is featured in some folk song books. You'll find them maybe in the, probably in the Berea collection. And there's a lot of stuff in there. Y'all are just seeing one side of it, okay? There's two or three more. She's a guitar player, and she's a banjo player, and she'll pick up a mandolin, she'll go to a piano and try to play it. Ora, did you bring something in your purse?
Oh, I got some.
That'll be later. We're gonna find a time later. She's a spoon player. And
we also have some tapes.
Oh, yes, please.
And on the tapes, Ora does sing and play the guitar. Don't think you play any banjo on that, but there's four or five songs that she sings by herself that are really nice on the tape.
They're special. And we've got a few, not enough. We got a cassette recording that we made with her. It's called Ora Watson and the Laurel Creek String Band. And we backed her up and put her out in the front. And we're grateful that the North Carolina Folklife Council section funded that project and helped us get it off the ground. We're now having to just order. She, everywhere she plays, she sells because they'd see how good she is. And I'll also mention that I've got a recording out there that more features me, a lot of gospel music and a lot of folk songs, and it's dedicated to my dad, and it has a bunch of songs on there I learned from him. We're going to end with a shape note gospel tune. I was fortunate to grow up in a church where we still had a shape note singing school teacher who was the choir director, and there were people on every voice part that sang shape notes. I became the church pianist for years, and Ora spent several years of her life at Cove Creek Baptist Church singing the same songs I was singing, and look at the, there's a little bit of difference of age here, okay? And she and I know a lot of the same gospel songs. It's just ridiculous when we get started. It's just a joy to do it with her. This one's called I Feel Like Traveling On.
since about the 15th century, I've been told, out of England.